Welcome to Community Connection. I'm your host, Sarah Clark, and today with me I have Joyce McCullough, Executive Director of Habitat for Humanity of Southern California, and John Peterson, the Associate Executive Director. Thank you so much for coming on the show today.
It's our pleasure. Thanks for inviting us.
So I'd love to hear a little bit about Habitat for Humanity and what its history in Santa Barbara and more about the organization and our community.
Thanks, yeah. We've been in Southern Santa Barbara County now for about 14 years, and it was started by groups of volunteers that got together and decided that there was definitely a need for affordable housing, and also really committed to the idea of home ownership for low-income families. And so that's what we do. We're one of the few providers of ownership housing for families in low-income strata of our society. So we're just delighted that they thought of that. And so we have built about 7 homes in the past years, and now we're in the middle of constructing 12 more. So we're very excited to see this whole groundswell of activity with Habitat.
Yeah, it's very exciting. I've been hearing about the buzz around town. So John, tell me a little bit more about this current project.
Yeah, we're really excited about this. This is our largest project and most ambitious by far. It's 12 townhome units for 43 people, 20 children who will be living there. We're really excited about it. It's right in downtown Santa Barbara, just off Milpas on Cannaburrito. It's not only is it our largest, it's our most green project, so we're excited about the impacts for the families and for the community that they will have. It will be affordable not only by design with their mortgage from us, but also in the maintenance and utilities because of how well the home is being built. So we're really excited.
So I'm sure there's obviously a long process that goes into a project like this, and then selecting the families that get to own these homes. Can you talk a little bit about how that process works and how you select these families?
Sure, and the first thing I want to do is dispel any myth that it's any kind of a giveaway program. This is a very labor-intensive selection process that we go through. And we have 3 primary criteria that we're looking at. First of all, we're looking for families that are willing to partner with us, and that means that they will be putting in 250 hours per adult family member working alongside our volunteers to build their home. The second is ability to pay, because they do pay a mortgage, and we calculate that mortgage based on their annual income, so it's affordable for every family that moves in there. And then thirdly, it's the need. And so as we're doing the selection process, we have a great committee of very dedicated volunteers that, first of all, look at all the financial information that's provided to us, just like a regular mortgage applicant would do. But then we also make visits to where people are living. And we often talk about the pockets of poverty in Santa Barbara in this county. And they can be well hidden, but when you make an effort and go out and look at where folks are living, it's astounding. They are living in overcrowded conditions because rents are so high they have to double and triple up. They're living in maybe passively and maybe not passively converted garages and little one-room places and places with no plumbing, no heating. And they're raising children there. And so we want to bring families out of that untenable situation into a safe, decent, affordable home.
Wonderful. I mean, I'm sure there's a long line of people applying for that. It must be a tough job to choose the right families.
It really is. It's heart-wrenching, and it was made even more difficult, especially on this last project. We had orientation meetings that we held around the whole area, and we had over 500 applicants for these 12 homes. So obviously some were not qualified based on our criteria, but at some point we had to make the decision of which of the 12 families best met our criteria. So we know there's definitely a need. We want to continue building in our service area.
So. Great. And how do you affordably build a home in a community like Santa Barbara, where I know construction costs can be really high?
Yeah, we really are a community-based organization, and we tap into every area of the community to do it. We have received some government support. This project, we purchased the land with the last of the RDA funds from the city of Santa Barbara. We get foundations and corporations who donate and come out for work days and support us that way. And then we just have tons and tons of individuals who support us, large gifts as well as regular monthly gifts of $25. It all adds up and helps us to make these homes affordable. And then another big piece of what makes it possible for us is the professional support we get in this town. We have contractors and material providers who give us discounts, who give us donated materials, and then people may know about the Habitat Restore. Some of the products that are donated there we use in our homes. So we're looking at ways to save costs and make these homes affordable, but decent and healthy.
And you touched on the Restore. For our viewers that aren't familiar with that, tell us a little bit more about that, because I know that's a big part of the organization here in town. I hear a lot about it, at least.
We're very proud of our Restore, and everybody should come and visit it, because we have a wonderful staff that's dedicated and committed. We get fabulous donations of inventory. So, for instance, when a homeowner is contemplating a remodel, if they've got usable building materials, we will have them delivered to the Restore, and then we feel like we're serving additional families, because homeowners that could not otherwise afford the high cost of building materials can come and get great bargains on building materials to do their own remodel. So we're kind of paying it forward. That money also helps to offset our fundraising needs. But one of the other key goals is that we're keeping usable building materials out of the landfill. And when you're in construction, it really, that's one of the biggest impacts on our landfill is construction debris.
And where is the Restore? So we can make sure
people
know
where it is. The Restore is located in Goleta at 6860 Cortona Drive. It's near the intersection of Hollister and Stork, just kitty corner from the Home Depot.
Mm-hmm. Great. And let's talk a little bit more about all the building and the community's help with that is going into the current project. I know that our employees here at Cox are really excited to have a volunteer day. We're coming out in April to help build these houses. So what are the opportunities for people that want to get involved and other volunteer opportunities to help support the organization?
Yeah, we love to have corporate groups come out and any community groups and others. That's really a big part of, like we talked about, how we make it affordable. And we're happy to have groups come out. They can visit our website, sbhabitat.org. You can sign up as individuals there, or you can sign up and have a group day. We have large groups come out and help to support the cost of their work for that day, so a minimal donation along with your volunteer time. And like I said, all individuals are welcome to come out as well. And if you visit our website, you can find out other ways to get involved. There's a space to donate and help support the project financially if you're not able to come out to the site. You can sign up or find out the dates for our what we call Habitours. Our next one is on April 9th, and they're a chance for people to come out and tour the site and see the homes at 5 o'clock on an evening and just kind of get a sense of what the project looks like from the inside.
And do you ever get the opportunity to work with some of the homeowners or meet them as a volunteer? Because I think that would be really exciting to work alongside some, you know, these people that are going to be living there.
Yeah, the families are working away at their sweat equity. We actually have a couple of families that have completed their 250 hours, and they still come out because, of course, now it's getting exciting to see how their house is getting finished. So that's one of our favorite things, is to watch volunteers and homeowners together working on someone's future home where they'll raise their family. It's really wonderful.
That's so exciting. So. And tell me, so how long does a typical build project take?
Well, I will say this is not typical for us, because this is, as we said, our biggest by far. It's three times as big as our last project. So this project's been about 18 to 20 months to build. Typical projects range anywhere from 9 months to a year. They tend to be maybe a little bit longer than other construction projects because we utilize the volunteers, and we know that people can't come out 5 days a week, so we have volunteers on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. So that's about how long it takes.
Great. And once this project is wrapped up, what can we expect and look for ahead from Habitat and our community?
We're doing a lot of remodel projects. We're working with people that have groups of low-income families that live in a community, and we're hopeful that we can make a big impact in a neighborhood with paint and general spruce-ups, and that's in a program that we call A Brush with Kindness. And so we'll have a lot of opportunities for volunteers in those arenas.
And so can you give an example of what one of those projects might look like?
Sure. Yeah, we've done several of them in town. We've worked with several mobile home parks. We've replaced windows for a woman who was living there and taking care of her grandson. And so we were able to go in and replace all of her windows, do some landscape maintenance for her. She wasn't able to cover the cost of the new windows. And when we left, she said, "This is great. The new windows are letting the light into my heart." So it was a great project for us.
And I love that story. Thank you for sharing that. What is some of the other feedback from these families that you've received?
Well, it's just been really exciting to see what a permanent, stable home will do for a family. We have a number of our homeowners now that have had the courage to start their own businesses. So we've got small business owners. We've got one woman that went back to nursing school and she's taking on a whole new career. And then another single mom that actually came to us through St. Vincent's, and she and her daughter now live in a Habitat home, and she's just finishing up her master's degree in psychology. So
wow.
She's, with the stability of a permanent home, she's able to launch a career and really provide a future for her daughter.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much for coming in today, and thank you for all that you do for our community. And it's really inspiring to hear and exciting about how we can all be a part of it.
It's a pleasure.
Thanks, Mary.
And thank you for watching Community Connection. We'll see you next time.